to my channel. So basically in my previous beauty favorites video, I told you guys that I was on track to graduate in the spring, and that is actually not the case anymore. I am planning on staying one extra quarter of school. I will be a fifth year. That is literally what I dreaded the most when I was a freshman, but it's happening and it's fine. I believe in like a video a long time ago, I said that I wanted to be a chem minor. It never really happened because human bio just has so many requirements. There was no way I was going to finish in the 4 years if I took on a chem minor. But recently, my human bio requirements were actually cut down a lot, significantly. And I noticed that if I actually stayed one extra quarter school, I actually could pursue my chem minor. And that is what I'm doing. So right now I am a human bio major with a minor in chemistry. At least I'm pursuing that. Honestly, you guys, I've actually been thinking that I kind of want to pursue something in the chemistry field. A lot of things that I'm actually really interested in right now, when I'm looking up the requirements, they say majored in chemistry, biochemistry, chemical engineering, things like that. And so I thought it was actually in my best interest to go for the chemistry minor and just have some type of chemistry background. But honestly, it was just so last minute, and I'm in an upper division chemistry class right now, and oh my goodness, like I don't recognize anyone from my bio classes. You know, I had to use my own little tips that I did a video on, but I just feel like I'm in a different world. I really do enjoy it, but it's so different. It's actually a lot more difficult in my opinion. And you know, I did not know that you can make a derivative out of pibnert. Who would have thought? That's really just kind of an update on what's going on. I'm not graduating in the spring of 2015, like I mentioned in a video like literally a month ago, because now I'm pursuing this chemistry minor. So I will be here for an extra quarter. I will be here for the fall of 2015. But yeah, so that's about it for that update. Let me know in the comments down below what you think about me becoming a chemistry minor. I'm actually personally really excited. I hope you guys are really excited for me. And for those of you guys who are pursuing a degree in chemistry, now I can relate to you guys more because I'm taking a bunch of those classes. So now I'm just going to get on with my favorites, and of course I'm going to start off with my makeup. So the first thing I want to talk about is this stippling brush. This is the e.l.f. stippling brush, and I actually kind of just forgot about this for a really long time, but I recently just kind of thought I would use my stipple brush, and I have just been loving the feel of it. It isn't as heavy as when I use those buffer brushes. It just gives a light application, but it just looks so airbrushed. I totally just rediscovered and fell in love with this. So my last makeup product are these Hard Candy metallic eyeshadows. These are amazing. I don't know why they don't get any more, like, that much more love on YouTube, because seriously, I feel like once people start realizing how great these are, like, no one's gonna stop. I don't know what I could compare this to. It's like a cream eyeshadow, but it does not dry like tacky and stay creamy or anything. So I only have two colors. I have Fake Bake 427, which is this beautiful bronze, and Golden Earth 426, which is my favorite one for those like pinky neutral eye looks. Oh my god, these are just amazing. You need the tiniest amount. I've had these for so long too. Because of the doe fat applicator, I would not recommend putting this all over your eye, just because I don't know, they're just, it just looks too big. Once it dries, you have to be really quick with them because they won't move. Like, they will not crease, they won't budge. You could use it as a base, but honestly, on their own, they are just so pretty. Oh my god. So I just swatched them on my hand right there. You can see, look at that shine. Like, I'm just going to take a clean finger. Like, look, nothing. Like, they just don't budge. They're just that amazing. I really recommend going and try these. They're really, I don't know how much they cost. I believe they're like $5.99, maybe $7.99, but so worth it. You're not gonna be able to finish this because you need the tiniest amount. So I just really enjoy this. So my next favorite has been this Mooncat scarf. This is the Principessa. I'm not really sure what type what the name of the scarf is, but I did a review on it. Go check it out. I will leave a link in the down bar, but I've just been really loving scarves in the month of January. I received this one during winter break, and so I've just been non-stop using it. Scarves in general, especially this one, really just been enjoying. The next favorite I want to talk about is I also got this over winter break, and seriously, it's been saving, I don't know, I've just been loving it. It's the most genius idea in my opinion. It is this, I have no idea what it's called, but it's this thing to like roll up your Mac charger. If you guys own a Mac and you have these chargers, you know how bulky these can get, just shoving it into your bag. And I always like kind of like worry that the cords are gonna tangle and it's gonna end up like just frying itself or something. So this thing is just a like very compact little disc that recoils the whole charger. Like, I swear, this is just so easy just to grab and just to put into my bag when I need my charger to go to the library. This is for the MacBook Pro, I believe, but I mean, it fits my MacBook Air charger fine. So basically, you coil it up in here. Let's see. Why is this so difficult? But see, you coil it up in here, and then you can actually adjust to how much you want out, sticking out. Kind of like maybe that much, maybe. And put that much, and then the rest you just kind of hide it in this little, pull it down, and it just looks, it's just so much more compact. Like, oh my god, I love this. I will leave a link to it down below because I believe my brother got it for me off of Amazon. Yes, thank you whoever this is, Quirky. Thank you, Quirky, for inventing this. Best idea ever. My next favorite has been this curling wand by Irresistible Me. It is the 8-in-1 sapphire one. Oh my god, I haven't owned a curling iron that has like all these different attachments onto it. There are 8 different attachments for this one wand. Like, I think these are the most genius ideas because then you don't have to buy a bunch of different curling wands. You can easily just snap these ones off and just place new ones. This is just a genius idea. I actually used it today and curled my hair. I used the 25-13mm. So it like the curls kind of start big on top and then they kind of go smaller and tighter down below. And then for my top layers, I use the 25mm just for my top curls because I don't like the top of my hair to be as tight. Just been really enjoying this. I will be doing a review up on this wand really soon. I love this. It's new. Go check it on their website if you're interested in one of these, because at the moment, yeah, like it's amazing. And my favorite app has been Venmo. I cannot open the app and show you guys because it's like personal and stuff, but Venmo has literally saved my life, like financially, I guess. So I don't know about you guys, but let's just, like, sometimes, you know, when you're on like a big dinner, like you're at dinner with a bunch of your friends and you have only one tab, and sometimes they can split the credit cards, but that's just a hassle, you know. And so what Venmo allows you to do is one person pays it and then basically everyone can just Venmo you money through your own credit card. Like, it just makes everything so much easier. You can just like request money from a person and they honestly have no excuse not to give you the money. Like, thank you, Venmo. Thank you, Venmo, for existing. And my house uses Venmo for everything. For groceries, for rent, we use it for everything. And it just makes life just so much easier. I'm not sponsored to talk about this app. I just completely just enjoy it. And my last favorite is, my favorite song of the month has been Elastic Heart by Sia. If you haven't seen the video, I really recommend checking it out. It's a little strange, but, oh, my roommates are home. Okay, yeah, I gotta wrap this up. So thank you guys so much for watching, and I'll talk to you guys in my next video. Bye!